சார் எனக்கு எந்த மெயில் அனுப்புறீங்க
இங்க நான் ஒரு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் வச்சிருக்கேன்
சார் Sir, kindly mute, sir.
Yes, sir, I am on.
Kindly mute your side, sir.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Kutagirba, you can stop.
Good evening to all the wonderful people present here. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to this great lecture. Maths is the language of the universe. The more equations you know, the more you can converse with the cosmos. Yes, everything around us is mathematics. Life is a mathematical equation. In order to gain the most, we have to know how to convert the negatives into positives. These words say how a person should take his life and lead it positively. One of the most amazing things about mathematics is the people who do math aren't usually interested in any other art forms, because mathematics itself is a beautiful art form. Let's get into the event. Small cheer and great welcome makes a merry feast. It is a jubilant opportunity to welcome you all. Firstly, I would like to welcome our teacher and our vice principal, Dr. Murugan sir, for this great evening. Now, I would like to extend my warm welcome to the distinguished chief guest, Dr. P. Kandan sir, assistant professor, Department of Mathematics, Government Arts College, Chidambaram. We welcome you, sir. Next, I would like to welcome all the faculty members who renders their hard work for the upliftment of the students. Welcome, teachers. Last but not the least, I happily welcome all the freshers who are ready for the race of learning. Welcome, freshers. Once again, I welcome everyone who are the part and parcel of this event.
Muthukirba, kindly 1 minute. 1 minute. Muthukirba?
Yes, sir.
1 minute. I think some audio issues, ma. Please wait. I will check with the participants. Please wait.
Okay.
Yeah, you can continue.
Should I start in the first, sir?
No issues, no issues.
Okay. Words are powerful. They live forever and have the power to truly guide us and impact us in our lives. May I now invite Dr. Vijayalakshmi ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Maths, to give the introduction to the Honorable Chief Guest of the Day, Dr. P. Kandan sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Government Arts College, Chidambaram.
Guest to the gathering. Dr. P. Kandan pursued his MSc, MPhil, PhD in various universities and has 14 years of teaching and research experience. He has presented research papers in many national and international conferences and published around 20 research articles in various reputed journals. He also guided MPhil students and one PhD research candidate pursuing his doctoral degree. He associated with membership in professional bodies like Bose Science Society, Academy of Discrete Maths and Applications, the Ramanujan Mathematical Society. He was honored with Best Senior Educator and Scholar Award. He has received Srinivasa Ramanujam Best Scientist Award for Mathematics from Tamil Nadu Scientific Research Organization. He authored many textbooks, Allied Maths 2 under Madras University syllabus, Topological Indices of Sum Graph Operations and Its Applications under Madras University syllabus. Such a versatile personality. Once again, on behalf of our institution, I welcome you, sir, for our guest lecture. Now, I invite Dr. P. Kandan, sir, the chief guest of today evening, to deliver his lecture. Stage is yours, sir. Thank you.
Hi, audible, ma'am? Okay, right. So, good evening to everyone. So, this is Dr. P. Kandan. I'll first thanks to the giving such an opportunity from the SRM institution. And I have thanks to a nice introduction by Dr. Vijayalakshmi Madam and their organizing team for providing such a nice platform to interact with the younger generation, the students. So once again, I say good evening to everyone. Those are all creating this program. So in the past 2 weeks, there are movements or developing. As we have our knowledge, and to develop our care, we have to think it about the new techniques and technology. So for all these, we need to have a good, a sound knowledge in our basic thing. Whatever things we study, we have to be sound in our basic things, right? That too, the students are from engineering side, so they have to be updated in their application concepts, application oriented. So to go for the field application, they have to try to take our knowledge in that direction. Continuation, we have to be sound in mathematics also. As a engineering peoples, we have to be sound in the science also. So that too, particularly in the field of science, in mathematics, one of the important topic, the subject is the matrix theory. So it is almost applied in many mathematics subjects. So today my lecture is on matrix and its application. I'm just going to share my PPT. So thank you. So this is my topic. So matrices and its application. So we are all familiar the term as second itself. So the term matrix was first introduced by Sylvester in 1850. He defined the matrix to be an arrangement of terms. So it's a sum terms. Then laterly, in 1858, Cayley outlined the matrix algebra, defining addition, multiplication, scalar multiplication, and inverse, like the extension of numbers. Here also the matrix concept is extended to the sum operations. So then only the subject is developed in vast manner. So the matrix, it is not only in the mathematics field, it is applied almost in many the emerging subjects. So matrix is a rectangular array or an arrangements of entries or elements displayed in a particular manner. That manner it is defined as a row and a column. So which is put it in a square bracket or parenthesis. So the entries are, it may be a real number or it may be a complex, not enough only the numbers. It may be go for polynomials, maybe other expression also. So it is normally denoted by the capital letters like A, B, C and so on. So here are some examples. So if you consider the matrix, the A, it's the 1-4 denotes the first row, 2-5 denotes the second row, and 3-6 denotes the third row. Similarly, if you think it about the column wise, 1-2-3 denotes the first column, and 4-5-6 denotes the second column. So similarly, one can think it about the 3-by-3 matrix. So more formally, the matrix or a matrices in a plural is a simply an array of numbers. So another example here I am given. So normally it is put it in the general form by the notation like this, capital A, it is A11, A12, and so on, A1n. So it's denoted the first row, similarly the second row, A21, A22, and so on, A2n. So it is in the general form. Maybe this can be put it in very simple way as written in a parenthesis, AI with M rows, N columns. So here AIJ, where I denotes row and J denotes the column. In the above matrix, there are M rows and N columns. So in shortly, it is M by N matrix. So it denotes the dimension or size of the matrix. So one of the example, we construct the matrix, capital A, with the condition AIJ is nothing but I minus 2J. So here, a 3-by-2 matrix we are going to construct. So naturally, if I take, I have to take the IS up to 3 and JS up to 2. So therefore, the matrix is of the form A11, A12, A21, A22, A31, and A32. So it is naturally we can observe from the formula AIJ equal to I minus 2J. So varying this I and J value, we can easily observe that A11 is minus 1. A12 is nothing but 1 minus 4, that is minus 3, and so on. So we can obtain the matrix like this. So now talking about order or size of the matrix. So already I recall it, so therefore I'll skip off it. So here is the general form. So the order means what here? It is nothing but the number of row and denoting the number of columns. So therefore, the previous example we observed that it is a 3-by-2 matrix. So their order is 3-by-2. So if the I and J are same, then we say that that matrix is the square matrix. We are going to see that one laterally. So here the types of matrices we are going to discuss. So the first thing, row matrix. So what is row matrix means? We have only one row. So in other words, the I is nothing but 1. Then J may be variant. So one of the example, A is 1 minus 7, 4. It denotes the row matrix of order 1 by 3. So similarly B and C. Even C is also a matrix. Similarly, the column matrix, here J is fixed as 1 and I is variance. So that is the example here. I'm given A, B, C. Square matrix. So square matrix means what? Nothing but I and J are same. So here there are some examples given. A as 2, 4, 6. It is the square matrix of order 2. So that is 2-by-2 matrix. Or simply we say that the order is 2. So similarly, the 3-by-3 matrix, that is order of 3. So this is called the square matrix. And what is the meaning of diagonal matrix? So diagonal matrix means, so all the diagonal entries, in other words, if I and J are same, in that case only the at least one entry is non-zero and the remaining entries are totally zero. Right? Or a little bit clearly, we go for the next definition, the triangular matrix. So triangular matrix means the diagonal entries and more than that one, that entries are non-zeros. And similarly for lower triangular matrix, in the same case, the diagonal entries below that one are all non-zeros. The remaining entries are zeros. So that is the triangular matrix. So therefore, naturally one can expect the diagonal matrix, only the diagonal entries are not these four entries. And the so next one is scalar matrix. So naturally we can expect it is the form of. So for any scalar value, we can talk about the scalar matrix. 5 0 0 5. So here pull it out the constant part, that is the scalar value, and we put it as a simply 5 into the identity matrix 1 0 0 1, right? So in other words, we can take some the constant value from the matrix. So then such a matrix is called the scalar matrix. So identity matrix or unit matrix. So what it means? So the diagonal entries are simply 1. The both upper and lower triangles are 0. So here are the example. So I2 means what? It is 2 by 2 matrix. The diagonal entries only 1. The 1 and the remaining are zeros. So similarly, I3. So naturally, in numbers, one can compare the number, whether it is lesser or greater, or it may be equal. The similar technique here also, one can talk about equal or not, the same or not. So in that case, how we can compare it? So the property is going like this. So I consider two matrices, VAJ. So and I can say that these two matrices are same if the all I and capital A and capital B are identity, that is equal, sorry. So such a matrix is called the so X, Y, Z, W, which is equal to 4 3 1 5. So when these two with corresponding X matrix on the right hand side. So X must be 4, Y must be 3, Z must be 1, and W must be 5. So then you see that is here. The transpose of a matrix. So what is transpose means? Just change the. In other words, just we are considering AIJ is AJI. So that is the transpose of matrix. So here one example I have given, capital A, 4 minus 3 2 0 1 5. So here the first column 4 2 1 reflected in the first row of the A transpose. So similarly, the second column row. So that is called the transpose of your matrix. So again, naturally we can talk about the multiplication of matrix. I think I recall it. So scalar matrix means, I think I'll skip off here. So here one example is also given, A, A should multiply with the constant 2. So that is nothing but 2A. So similarly, the negative of a matrix. So what is the negative of matrix means? So here A is given. And what is minus A means? Just multiply each and every entry by minus M. So one can observe here, it is not only we have to give the real number, even we can go for the polynomial, I already recall it. So it may be a function. So here it's a trigonometric function, so the entry for the matrix A. And naturally one can extend the concept of the numbers in the different manner, right? Adding, subtracting, right? Division. So all those things, there are many operations in numbers. So similarly here also one can expect in matrix about their addition and subtraction. So how we can two different matrix. So the main thing here we are considering when we can add the two matrix, only if the two matrices A and B should be on the same order, then only we can add it. So here we consider the matrix A and B. So how we are adding A plus B? It is like this. If A is AIJ and B is BIJ, then A plus B is what? AIJ plus BIJ. So what it means? The corresponding entry of the matrix A and the corresponding entries of B should be added. This is true for all I, j. So similarly, one can think it about the subtraction of the matrices. The same things, the corresponding entry should be subtracted. So you'll get the new matrix. So naturally, we can talk about the multiplication of the two matrices, right? So how we can start multiplying? So let's go for the example first, then I'll come back to the definition. So here on, I'll consider two matrices, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the, it is 2 by 3 matrices. Other one is the 3 by 2 matrices. So we are taking, so here comes in matrices, the first column, then multiply with the first row of the first matrices. So this is 1 into 10, then 2 into 20, then 3 into 30. So I get some value, just sum it up. So that is the first entry of the new matrices. So second entries, the second entries, you go for considering, or maybe you can fix it here and you can go for the second row also. That is also you can do it. So therefore, fixing the same column, so 10 into 4, so 20 into 4. And 30 into 6. So that is this entry, A21. So similarly, fixing the second column and multiplying operation here, we'll get these two matrices. So after required modification, we'll get the new matrices. So this is the way the matrix multiplication is defined. So that is the things we are defined. So if A is M by N matrix and B is N by P matrices, so in this, the newly derived matrix should be of the form M by P, right? So here is the example one can easily observe. This is the case. Now, naturally, there are many operations are going on, but we are restricted with the basic operations. Now, let's talk about some properties. In group theory, in algebra, there are many properties. Maybe you're all familiar, I don't know. But the thing is, here also we can concept. So one of the famous properties here we recall it. So the first one is commutativity. So if you change what happened, so that is the commutativity. So under the addition of matrices, you check it A plus B. That is the matrix E B. Naturally, we can expect this result. This the equality is always 4. So the what is this meaning? That is adding the corresponding entry of A and B is same as adding the corresponding entries of B and E. So naturally, we can expect the commutative property. So same concept applied for the associativity. So what is associativity? Instead of considering two matrices, we can go for three matrices. So that is the thing. So first adding B and C, then with A, which is same as adding A and B, then with C. So if you check it, the result in is or always equal. So similarly, the next one for multiplication, under multiplication also, that is, this is some constant part. Here we are multiplying. So I think I'll skip it this case. So these are all based on the scalar concepts. So distributive properties. So under addition and as well as the multiplication. So like this, we can go for the multiplication concept. So instead of addition, in the multiplication. So in numbers, naturally, we can expect the product of two numbers by changing the position, their place, it is always equal, right? For example, 4 into 5 is same as 5 into 4, but we cannot expect the concept in the matrix, right? So therefore, under multiplication of your matrices, the commutative properties get failed, right? So that is A, B, that is A matrix multiplication B is not always same with B with A. So, but in associativity, if you consider the three matrices, you are taking the product BC, then with A, and similarly AB, then with C, so it is equal. And similarly going for distributive properties. So distributive properties, it is the combination of multiplication and addition. So first you adding the matrices B and C, then with matrix multiplication with A, which is same as matrix multiplication of AB, and matrix multiplication of AC, then adding these two matrices. So that is the distributive property, we can check it. So multiplicative identity. So like numbers, you can multiply any numbers with 1, you get the same number. So like here also the same things will be happen. So I is the identity matrix. You can take with any matrices A, it is given the same value as the exist. Similarly, here O is what? Null matrix. So null matrix means all the entries are zeros. All the entries are zeros. So if you multiply with the null matrix with any matrices, then the resultant matrices is always null matrices. So these are all some basic properties based on the matrix multiplication. So here, based on the above properties and operations, one can check it this case. So if I consider the matrix A, 2x2 matrices, then easily one can find like a polynomial, right, a power 2. So what is a power 2? Is nothing but multiplication of matrix multiplication of a 2. So a square means that is power of a, right? So a into a, right? So that is a. Again, I'll put some value. So that is the a square. Then what is minus 7a? It is scalar multiplication. That is each and every entry with minus 7. So similarly, what is minus 2i? It's identity matrix. Then multiply each and every entry with minus 2. Here you'll get this value, right? So here we get the null matrices. So this is just applying the previous. So here also one more example. So naturally one can expect the entries are, we can view it as a vector form. So once we are viewing the vector, it has an enormous application. So here also we can, under the matrix concept, we can expect that each and every row or column, we can view it as a vector space. So under the vector space, these are all the important things. So here under the vector space, one can talk about where the, we can identify the object, where in the space, right? So for that purpose, the matrix multiplications are very powerful things, right? So here is one of the example. So to find the value of x, the multiplication of two matrices, 2x3, right? So this is 1x2 matrix, sorry, right? It's a row matrix. So here is a square matrix. Again, another a column matrix, right? So multiplying all this value, it is given as 0. Now we try to find the unknown value x. So just applying the matrix multiplication techniques. So this matrix into this multiplies, you'll get this one, right? Then multiply with the column matrix. Again, you'll get this one. So it is given that it is equal to 0. So from this, it is the equation, quadratic equation, you'll get it. So from here, we can try to obtain what is the value of x. So here, the value of x is either 0 or minus 3/2. So this is one of the powerful tricks. So these are all some examples. Maybe you can utilize this problems for talking about the previous properties. So these are all some examples, again, based on the properties of the addition of matrices and multiplication of the matrices, right? Now, again, one of the basic things on matrices is talking about the determinant. It is the powerful things nowadays. It is first introduced determinant concept. So it's discussed about the quadratic form. So if I consider the three coordinates x1, y1, I think I'll give this laterally, I'll come back. So this is one of the familiar form, you already know it's the area of a triangle. So let us come back this one, just go through it here. Laterally, I'll come back here. So determinant is defined like this. So for a given a simple things, for a given 2x2 matrices like this, then what is the meaning of determinant? It is going like this, right? It is put it in this format, right? It is put it in this format, right? So what is this one? A11 into A22, that is cross multiplying. Similarly, A12 into A21. Now, so this is talking about the determinant of 2x2 matrices. So similar operation we can extend for m by n matrices also. So here it's talking about the minus and the cofactors. So cofactors means you'll fix this one and the remaining things if you go for the higher order terms, right? And the other powerful things is what is singular and non-singular matrices. So based on the determinant concept, the meaning of singular, what is the meaning of singular is, if the determinant is equal to zero, then we say that the square matrix is the singular matrix. If not the case, that is, if it is not a singular, that is the determinant is not equal to zero, then we say that it is a non-singular matrix. So here is one of the example. A is a given. We can check it whether this is a singular or non-singular. So first thing is we have to try to find the determinant. So here we consider the 3x3 matrices, their determinant. So here we'll put it here. So this is the cofactors, right? So that is fixing this value. That is either way we can do it. So here we'll consider the first row only. So I'll fix this one, then omit this column and omit this row and taking the remaining as a minus, right? So they are determinant. So that is the here we'll put it. Next one, alternate sign. So here once you consider here, then you have to go for the alternate sign as a minus, right? So here plus, then minus, then plus, it's going on like this. So now the minus 2, right? So omit the similar way, this column and omit this row, right? And the remaining things 4, 6, 7, 9, and take their determinant. So this is the minus of the cofactor 2, right? So similarly, fixing this 3 alternate sign, right? So plus, minus, then plus. So here again, omit this column, omit this row, and take the remaining things. That is, the we'll get this. So if you simplify all those things, we will get 0. So naturally, this matrix is talking about a singular matrix. Now some properties of determinants. So maybe by studying when the properties of determinants when you're in your subject. So the first property is talking about the value of determinant is unaltered by interchanging its row or column. So this is the powerful property. So once you are interchange the row or column, their determinant does not change. So the value is fixed. So that is the important thing. So similarly here, the other thing, the next property. So any two row of a determinant are interchanged, the determinant change its sign, but its numerical value is unaltered. So if you took partially interchanging, then there's suddenly changed. So that is here starting. The other one is if two rows of a determinant are identical, then the value of the determinant is zero. So this also, if suppose there are two rows or columns, their values are identical, then naturally we can expect their determinant is zero. The last property. So if you the elements is multiplied by some constant terms, the scalar times the determinant of the given matrix A. So the thing more is given. Also based on the determinant properties, one can try to find the unknown value X. So that is the one of the examples here I'm given. So this is one matrix and this is another matrix. Now try to find the value of X, right? So based on the value of X. So similarly, based on the determinant concept, we can obtain the matrix. Maybe you can enjoy in your degree level. So I'll just at the moment, I just only recall the basic things, right? Now, what are the things really above? We try to find some applications. So then only the students can enjoy the lecture, right? So applications, right? So what are other things? Now we see it, the above slide, some application. So why we need to study all those things? So that is the major question from the student sides or the readers, right? So we try to find some application, not all applications on what are the things we studied in the previous slides. So let us try to give some applications. So first thing is matrices. We'll start with matrices. To use to understand the design or the content of an object in a real life, when put on a paper, we always try to put it in the block format. So that is the matrix. matrix. So you're all, the students are familiar in matrix concepts. So we'll start with where, so here some examples, right? So I'll give the some figures here. So matrices are a way to categorize the elements into the this structure, right? So we can put it in the matrix statement, right? As a block, right? So whole elements we can put it in the block. So where is the height is there? Where is the length is there? Where is the breadth is there? Right? So where is the changes in the structure? So all those things we can try to put it in the matrix. That is block elements, right? Even we can see in the day-to-day life, the many things are going on matrix concept. So a basic example is chessboard. So chessboard can be put it in the matrix. It is one of the arranging the matrix concept. Similarly, the calendar. So calendar, in the olden days, the calendars are totally different, right? It is very horrible to the calendar, not easily way to read it. So now, after the matrix is once come, so it is very, put it in very short form, right? Even many people are trying to put the calendar for at least 10 years or some things in a single paper also, right? So everything is possible under the matrix state. So even the pixel of TV. So in the olden days, the TVs are not clear, right? Because there is no that much technique is available. So once the matrix concept is introduced, any images can be transformed into matrix techniques, right? So with the help of that, now we can see the wonderful pictures in the TV, right? So in the olden days, if you see it, maybe many people, I don't think so, maybe aware or not. In olden days, the TVs, their picture tube is very, now it is very shorter. It is nowadays to the smart TV, LED TV, LCD TV, even the TVs are coming, right? So everything is based on this technique, right? Again, here also we can think it's nowadays the atmosphere and temperatures or maybe the climate changes, easily we can view or easily in advance also we can predict what is the climate, right? So what is the today climate. So all those things easily we can immediately get it, right? So we can put it in this format, right? So that is, we are scaling, that scale can be put in the matrix techniques. With the help of matrix techniques, there is a program. So you can predict our the future case. So even this is the thing, the 3D vector field. So rotate it, all those things. Maybe nowadays you can see that this 3D printing or just on that. So keys, right? So our keyboard. And in on the way on max. So previous things. So latitude and longitude. So get in the so we can zoom it, or we can try to find the exact. So many things we can view from heard from the news, right? This maybe the image is not clear. It will be the high people's vulnerabilities and other things. Try to find the exact. The ancient space time. So everything's put it in the orbit. We can put it only in four dimension, right? So in the four dimension cases only. So three dimension spaces and one dimension orbit. So here this is the time, one dimension. So and this is the 3D. So matrix is more helpful in these cases also. So just we some the transpose of matrix, right? So the matrix we studied, but so here we can see one of the image. So here you try to rotate or rotate. So how we are rotating? So everything is put it in the matrix blocks, their values, then I try to rotate it. That is with the help of the transpose. In other words, geometrically, just we are rotating. Okay. So that is the thing. So this is the original matrix. The images can be put into matrix. Now I try this and come here and send it. So here I try 180 degree. So after taking a transpose on the original matrix, it is look like this. Okay. So maybe the basic things from the windows, we can see this. We can change their here. Our thing is again taking 180 degree to an image. Okay. So it is nothing but with the help of the transpose of your matrix. So one of the application, right? Even the diagonal of your matrix. Yes, so we discussed, right? So where it is applied, the diagonal of your matrix, right? We need a particular. The diagonal should be the remaining things or should be changed, right? So based on the names or sometimes some figures, right? All those things you have to apply the diagonal matrix concepts, right? So a simple example, this is the axis. This is the axis, right? Now in the diagonal matrix, so this won't be changing. This is always fixed. Always fixed. Applying the transpose for this, right? That is for this figure. So things we get it, right? This figures are does not change, but the remaining figures are changed their positions. So this is talking about diagonal of your matrix, right? So all these things, it is helpful for the graphic structure concept. Even determinant. So determinant, we can you imagine whether determinant is helpful for the application? Yes, it is helpful, right? So what is the determinant? That is the volume nu . So based on this figure, we construct the new figure, right? So here is one of the cube figure. So it has a four copies, right? So what is the determinant is talking about? So this, the new volume over right. So we can imagine, or we can visualize the determinant of the part. The shape of determinant, one can talk about the area of a triangle. So there I talk about the general values, right? So here we'll consider like this x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So that is the things. Now connecting all these things by scaling such a area, right? We connected this. So with the help of the previous the determinant formula, we can easily observe that under this area, we talk about their that is triangle of this area, right? So with the help of determinant. So these are the things, area of the triangle, we are already familiar. So here we apply the determinant concept, right? So it may be, so it's a plus and minus, or it is depending upon their where we are choosing, right? So this is they're talking about the area. Now again, another example in this function. Okay, naturally, if I get three coordinates, whether it is lying in a straight line, right? So that is called collinear points, right? Collinear points. So here we consider three coordinates, 0, 1, 4, right? So these are lying in a single straight line, right? So such a line is called the collinear points, right? So here is another example, 0, 1, 2, 2, I think the same things. If three coordinate does not lie in a straight line, then we say that it is not a collinear, right? And the other one is the Cramer's rule. So Cramer's rules also, it is based on the determinant concept. So that is the unknown value for a given system of equation. We try to find the unknown variables, right? So you have a system of equation like a11 x1 plus a12 x2, right? Like that. So you have the unknown variables, n number of unknown variables with n number of equations. Then we try to find the n values, that n variables. So with the help of Cramer's rule, so naturally the Cramer's rules are defined in terms of determinants, right? So the unknown variables, we can easily find it. So all those, the Cramer's rules, it's applied in many fields, because always we are facing, trying to solve the system of equations in many fields, right? So So for example, in the stochastic process, probability, right? Operation research, right? Even in differential equation. So many, many fields, solving the system of equation is one of the major issue. So we try to settle it. So for that, the easiest way is the, one of the rule is the Cramer's rule, right? So here, what is this meaning? That is for a given matrix, that is its determinant, and A1 is nothing but the minor matrix, right? So already we discussed one of the things. And the next important thing is eigenvalue and eigenvector. So you are all familiar with this also. Lambda x. So, or in shortly, Ax equal to x, right? And a lambda, which is unknown value, x is a vector, right? So if this is hold the matrix into the vector, x is some vector. If it is equal to some constant time x, then we say that this lambda is eigenvalue, and this such a vector is called eigenvector, right? So here we discuss that is A is n by n matrix and lambda is a scalar, x is a non-zero vector in the n dimension, a Euclidean space, right? So what is the meaning, the exact meaning of eigenvalue? So eigenvalue is nothing but talking about the distance. It is talking about the distance, and this x talking about the direction, the where in our undergraduation. But the lambda denotes here stretching the concept, right? Stretching the figures. So in stretching, trying to stretch the figures, right? So in that position, we need what is the eigenvalue. Right. Similarly, the direction, maybe I want the figure in the first quadrant or second quadrant or third quadrant like that, right? So where and all we want, we can change their position. Therefore, it is a powerful things in many application field. What is the eigenvalue and eigenvector, right? So here is one of the example I'm given. So from origin to here, it is denoting the vector, that is the direction, and lambda is what? It is how we are stretching. That is the important things, right? So this will be stretched. So based on the matrix, we are talking the eigenvalue and eigenvector, right? So maybe some more applications. Nowadays, once you go for the Google, so you'll immediately get some many pages. The what is the things you are type? There is a pages. It is in particular manner. So what you are expected, what you are typed, that will be put it in the a particular order. So how that order is appeared? So it is clearly based on this eigenvalue and eigenvector. So here, one of the example, so there are six pages appeared in a particular manner, right? But why the first pages is appeared? What is the reason? So let us discuss this a simple example. So there are six pages are appeared, what you are searching in the Google. So meaning is the Google giving the rank for the first page, something, second page, similarly third page, some rank is given. So that rank, it is based on the matrix concept, that is precisely eigenvalue and eigenvector. So here, so this is the first page, second page, third page, then fourth page, fifth page, sixth page. So there is some rank is given. So here, how this matrix, put it in the matrix form, this is there. That is for one, there is a outgoing for two, right? So similarly three, that is from 2 to 3, and from 1 it is 4, from 1 it is 5, and from 1 it is 6, right? So I'm giving some certain value, and divided by 2, that is the thing. So here, one of the things I'll put it in the matrix. So maybe from here, this is 1, right? So from 1 to 2, I'll give the some a value 1 by 4, right? So similarly, this is 3. There is no connection from 1 to 3, therefore it is 0. And from 1 to 4, there is the connection, right? So therefore I'll give that value 1 by 4. Similarly here, for 5, it is connection is there, 1 by 4. Similarly for 1 to 6, there is that, therefore it is 1 by 4. So similarly, we can give each and every values here, right? And based on this matrix A, we try to find the eigenvalue. So we already know it, the determinants. So A minus lambda I. So that is the things. And we put it, this is equal to 0. and we'll get what is the eigenvalues. Lambda is like this, lambda is like this. So we get a lambda as like this, right? And we try to observe. These are all the values, right? But the thing is, we always try to give some rank in the positive interval. So here we observe it. This is negative value. This is negative value, right? And the only one is the positive value, right? So therefore, for the page rank one, the lambda equal to one, we give the page rank, right? So here similarly, we can try to find the eigenvector also. So we get this eigenvector is like this, so 4 1 0.5, and like this. So if you observe it, in this case the page 5 is get the biggest value. The page 5 get the biggest value, therefore we are giving the 5 as the highest page rank, because 8 is the maximum value. Therefore the corresponding things is for. So therefore, this 5 will be appear in the top of the Google search, right? So this is the way, the one of the application with the help of eigenvalue and eigenvector talking in Google. So that's why the Google is so familiar. The next application, electronic field. So in electronic field, so this is the one of the circuit it is given, an example, right? We try to put it in the differential equation form. So there are two circuit we are considered, so left loop and right loop, right? So this is the differential equation. So again, this can be rewrite in the matrix form, put it in this way, the general form, dk by dt equal to ak plus. So where k is what? It's talking about this I1, I2, the unknown things. Similarly, a is nothing but the matrix form, we can put it that the coefficient of I1, similarly here, I2 and here, so that one is in place, right? And v is 120, 81, that is this one, I'll take it to the other side. So these are the things. So everything we'll put it in the matrix form. So A, B, K. Again, we'll try to find the eigenvalue. So we'll get lambda 1 like this, corresponding eigenvector like this, similarly lambda 2, V2. So from here, we'll get what is the value of K. So that is the important things we want, the unknown things K, right? So this is the way the powerful thing eigenvalue is applied in, even in electronic field. So one of the example I just gave. Similarly, even in the genetics field also, we can expect this case, right? So matrix eigen can be mathematical model of describing the inheritance in a given population, right? So here talking about inheritance, the matrix eigenvalue and diagonalization is very important things to apply in genetics, right? Not only in that field, it's many fields, it's the matrix is applied. So one of the other field talking about the communication systems, right? So in communication system, the eigenvalues are used by a cloud share. So to determine the theoretical limit to how much the information can be transmitted through a communication medium like our telephone line or through the air, right? So based on the eigenvalue, so how much information can be transformed. So that is the powerful things, right? Sometimes the military people need the powerful line, right? So they want. So such a things, the eigenvalues will be more, right? So this is one of the important things in communication system. So similarly, designing a bridge. So maybe you can know it in the older days. So now the bridge is the very financially it is appeared in many sites. There is actually it's having a big budget to design the bridges, but it is get collapsed, right? So then laterally we can observe it. It is the main problem is in the frequency. So again, eigenvalue is talking about the frequency, right? Whether you will get we have this much of load can be applied here or not. So for studying that one, the engineer should know the model and stability of the construction. So for that purpose, the eigenvalue is the more important, right? Whether is there is any earthquake or any disaster is there, whether this bridge will be capable to manage, right? Whether it is working or not. So in that case, the eigenvalue is more important, right? Even in the car stereo system, right? Nowadays the cars and all, we have the stereo systems, but very nice music. Not olden days, we cannot enjoying such a way. So in that car stereo system also, we can apply this eigenvalue concept, right? So talking about the music, right? Again, in the electrical engineering, I already given one of the examples. So eigenvalue and eigenvector is useful for decoupling three-phase system through symmetric component transformation. Again, in the mechanical engineering, it's talking about reducing the linear operation to a separate simpler problem. For example, already one of the example I've given, the stress, talking about the stress is applied to the plastic or solid, the deformation can be dissected into a principal direction, right? So how much stress is we can apply in a particular material so that we need or we can get the required structure, right? So that is the important thing. So in that case, we need what vector we can apply, right? And what is the eigenvalue we can apply so that we can get the nice molding structure, right? So in that case, the eigenvalue and eigenvectors are applied. Right. Not only in the mechanical field, so here is another example in the oil companies, eigenvalues is applied. So where is the oil and resources are available? So that one they can get it with the help of eigenvalue and eigenvectors, right? So this is the one of the things. And other field, the important thing is the chemical engineering, right? So in chemical engineering, so here is one example. I take a molecular structure. So in this structure, they put it in the graph. So in mathematics nowadays, it's a very trending subject, a graph theory. So here they construct the molecules converted to the graph structure. So here is the things. Only they consider the carbon, so more attractive than other value, right? So here they consider like this. So this can be put it in the matrix. So that matrix is called adjacency matrix. So what is the adjacency matrix is, if there is a connection between the vertices, so this is called vertices 1, 2, 5, 3, 4, right? So it's a labeling. So it's a called a vertices. Between the vertices is nothing but the edges. So if there is a relation between the two vertices, then I can give the value 1, otherwise 0, right? So here there is a relation between 1 and 2. Therefore, so here we can label it like this. So here the column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Similarly here also the this one 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So with 1 to 1, there is no any relation. Therefore 0, and 1 to 2, there is a relation. Therefore 1. Similarly 1 to 3, there is no relation. 1 to 4, there is no relation. 1 to 5, there is no relation. Right? So 2 only there is a relation. Therefore we give 1. So similarly for each and every vertices we can give, and we try to find the adjacency matrices. Now from this matrices in the chemical engineering field, what they observe is, they observe that it is called, so you get right? So you just take all these eigenvalues. So this is correlated to the values called pi electron energy. In the chemistry field, it is called pi electron energy. So it's in the olden days, in trying to get this value is very complicated, or we have to spend more money. But after the many techniques, it is easily they get this value with the help of a simple matrix technique concept. So it is called the energy. So this is called energy. It is nothing the modulus of the eigenvalue. So this energy. Recently there are many kinds of energies are introduced, right? So not only energy, this one pi electron energy. Then we are talking about distance matrix also here. Distance matrix and many more matrices are nowadays we can see in the chemical engineering field with the help of graph theory. So even not only the matrix technique on this that conversion, maybe here also in chemistry side, one of the other thing is talking about the chemical reactions. So in the here talking about the kinetics, we can convert this structure to the matrix techniques. So with the help of this matrix techniques, we can study the kinetic, the chemical reaction of kinetics. And even in mechanics, one of the example I'll talk it here. So there I see a string or a suspected here under two cables, right? So AC and CB are two cables. So here we try to apply some load. So it is a 50 pound here given, applying the load, whether this cables are capable to hold this weight or not. So for this purpose, we are going for matrix concept, right? So here a weight is suspended from two cables, AC and BC, which are secured at a point A and B. Assuming that cables can support the weight and there is no motion, find the force in the two cables, right? So here, what are the force in these two cables? So that will be how it is applied nicely in matrix concept. So from the structure, we can convert it in this format with the angle and the force like this, right? And this can be converted into the equations like this, right? So from this concept, we can again put it in the matrix techniques with the help of these angles, right? And this is the force F1 and F2, that is this force AC and BC respectively. The main thing is we want to know what is F1 and F2. Now easily, once you convert it into the matrix techniques, easily we can find what is the F1 and F2, that is the eigenvector, right? So the eigenvector, they finally observe like this. So what is the tension, force or tension? This much of tensions are here. So if you go for more than this weight, then the tension will be increased, right? So in other words, this tension will be up to this value, it will be capped. Similarly here also the same case, right? So based on the matrix techniques, in the mechanic field also we can talk about this, right? So not only in this case, even in the software line, one can talk about the graph matrices. So how the software will be tested. So it is based on the cyclomatic complexity. Right? So here take one example. So this is the software in the software field. So here we consider like this, a graph matrix, right? So it's called a graph matrix. So there is some data structure can be developing with the help of tool automation. So it's a path testing, whether we can send the information out with a very good sense without any disturbance. So that one, with the help of cyclomatic complexity, we can talk about this case, right? So here is the things, this value. So this can be put into the cyclomatic complexity value. So in other words, here for from one, what about their value? So from one to one, there is a loop. It is called in graph theory, it's a loop. So therefore I'll give one value one, right? Similarly for one to two, there is a value. There is a link is there, therefore one. Similarly from one to three, there is a link, therefore it is a one. Now adding all those things and then subtract with one. So this is the standard format in cyclomatic complexity, right? This is the format. So therefore similarly, you can go for everything, right? And if there is no link, then you can put zero. So there is this meaning, right? So here, if you find this value under three different cases in the testing, so all the values are identical. So here we are talking about the matrix test. So now, so not only in the software field, so nowadays the military peoples or the higher officials, they try to convey the message without knowing for the third persons. If there is a confidential message, so how they will be conveying it? So in a different manner, right? Without knowing for the third person, they send it the message, right? Very confidential. So for that purpose, they go for trying to the new subject called the cryptography. So is the next one. So cryptography, okay, cryptogram is a message written according to a secret code. So in this called secret code, the message is written, right? So here also we are applying the matrix thing. So matrix multiplication can be used to encode and decode the message. So we have to send the message, right? So that message should be put it in secret manner. So for that, they use the word encode and decode, right? That is, the normal message can be first converted into the encoded form. It should not be, it may be readable, but they don't know the meaning. That is the encoder. So the only the corresponding persons who are receiving, they only know how to read that message with the help of some a key. So that is called decoding, right? So only that person can read that message. So this will be frequently you can know in the military side, right? The intelligence bureau, they use this technique, cryptographic transcription. So one of the example I consider here. So first thing is we have to assign some value. So this is the one of the technique only. There is many more things are going on in the cryptography. So basic things here. So we try to assign the value for blank space as zero, and for A I'm assigning one, and for B and 2 and so on. The alphabeticals, I'll put it up to 26, right? So this is the standard technique in the cryptography, assigning the alphabets as a numbers. So this is one of the message, meet me on Monday, right? So this one, I am going to say some person. I should not put it the same manner. I have to modify this one so that no one can read it. So M is nothing but 13, E is nothing but 5. Similarly, E is nothing, right? So I try to put it in the 1/3 matrix. First, so here I'm going to block it like this, 3, 3, right? So up to E, one block. Up to this E, T, M, E, it's another block. Again, T and the space is here, right? So that is also you have to consider. Up to M, one block. Again, E, space, then M. So it's another block. So similarly, it's going like this, right? And the other space, there is no alphabets here, then I have to put 0. That is also allowed. So here, this is the way they assigning the numbers. Now this can be put it in the matrix technique like this, right? Encoding the same. So for encoding, I use one other matrix, right? We can fix any matrix. So this matrix is called as a key. So this key should be known for only two people. So this is the matrix A. So this is the key. It is known by only two people, the sender and receivers, right? So this is we are given, we are creating. So with the help of this matrix, first I try to take this M, E, E. So this matrix to encoded form. So this is the things 13, 5, 5. So using this matrix A encoding message, now I code it like this. So 13 minus 26, 21. Now for corresponding 13, there is some value. There is some alphabets. Similarly, for minus 26, we can convert it into positive. Then we get some alphabets. Similarly, for 21, there is some another alphabet. So similarly, we can go for everything's, right? So everything's we are going to. Then we'll get the coded message. Again, by applying the inverse of your matrix, we can decode the message. Then we can read it easily. So this is the technique. These are the techniques for in a cryptography. One of the basic things. So maybe nowadays you can just go through the WhatsApp. What is the message that you are sending? That will be encrypted, right? No third person can be read it. Only end-to-end conversation, right? So in your mobile, you can see it in the WhatsApp. There is a this message, right? So this is the message you can see. So it's a matrix, right? You can this everything is a encryption concept. So it's a matrix concept only. The message what you are sending. In your mobile, you can see this this value, which is same things will be appeared for the persons who are received. The same value appeared in their mobile also, right? So meaning, what is this meaning? The third person cannot read it. Only you and the receiver can read their message. That is the meaning, right? So encryption, matrix concept. This applied in many social media also, right? Another example. Now let's come back to other some more fields. It's a seismic survey, right? Seismic survey, that is in the geology, the matrix are helpful to talk about the measuring the earth properties. In other words, meaning it's talking about the physical structures, their magnetic, electric, gravitational, thermal, and elastic fields, right? So based on this one, it will be helpful where the oil resources is available, right? And many other resources we can talk it. Not only for this one, maybe for the purpose also, the matrix are more applied, right? So not only in this field, maybe that is economics and business, commerce, right? So the matrix concepts are applied. So it is some example, a company with several outlets selling several different products, right? So that can be easily in the olden days into calculating all those things, maintaining their business. It's very horrible, right? It is tough. But nowadays, you know, with the help of matrix concept, easily one can calculate it. So they can put it in the matrix concept here. So there are some row and here some columns. So easily one can talk about what is their total, what is their diagonal values, all those things, many properties. So based on this property, easily the business can be improved. So similar. The matrix are applied. So not only this one, many more fields are applied. So like robotic automation, aeronautical engineering, there are also the eigenvalues are applied. Even electrical engineering, the concepts are recalled. Structural mechanics, that also recalled it, right? And even in the probability, ecology, because biology is based on the matrix concept also. There also the matrix are applied, right? So even more, the matrix are applied. So I have restricted only applications, not the entire things. I can't able to cover it. It is because it's a fast-moving subject and it's a very vast subject, right? To know the matrix applications, we have to study many books. So that much of applications are existing for matrix, right? So here I give just the essence of the, right? So only the music, I think many people's or attending this program. I think there is no any direct conversation. So I am not able to put any question also. So I think I'll stop here. I hope it may be helpful for students, communities, right, with the vision of this matrix concept in your future. So maybe you can enjoy in your class when you are studying the matrix concept, right? So I stop here. Thank you, one and all, the giving such a wonderful opportunity for me from SRM Valiyamma. Dr. Lakshmi Madam and their coordinators, Ms. Aarthi, Dr. G. Sasikala, and the head of the department, Dr. S. Chitra Madam, and for their organizing team. So once again, I thanks to everyone for giving a wonderful opportunity. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you so much, sir, for your wonderful lecture. We learned a lot about matrices and its application. The lecture picked up to learn more about the matrices and its use. You made us know that matrices are used even in the water. We feel proud and privileged to have you with us in this evening. Thank you so much, sir. Gratitude is the inward feeling of kindness. Thankfulness is the natural impulse to express that feeling. I now invite Dr. G. Sasikala Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Maths, to deliver the oath of thanks.
Ma'am, you can start, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Unmute your side, ma'am.
On behalf of Department of Mathematics, I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks. I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to our chief guest, Dr. P. Kandan sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Government Arts College, Chidambaram, who despite his numerous and rather tight schedule has found time to grace this occasion and gave a valuable guest lecture on matrices and its applications for our students. As a part of the learning process, your lecture motivated the young minds of the students in understanding and applying the concept of matrices and its applications. Thank you, sir. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to take place on record our hearty thanks to the management, principal sir, vice principal sir, FICC ma'am, for permitting the students to attend this lecture. I also extend my thanks to HOD Department of Mathematics, Dr. S. Chitram ma'am, for her continuous encouragement and support. And I would like to thank Association Coordinator Dr. V. Vijayalakshmi ma'am, Mr. Mohan sir, and all our faculties for supporting in all aspects, conducting the event successfully. Last but not least, I would like to thank all our first year students, those who have attended this lecture. Once again, thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am, for your words of gratitude. Feedback forms will be posted in your WhatsApp group. Students are requested to fill the feedback form.